policy analysts also believe a deal in Denmark with strict emissions limits is not within reach. They do think that commitments from China, India, and Brazil are key to any progress in world discussions. Dee Bombani was at a discussion at the Brazil Institute about emerging economies' role in climate talks. Good morning, Dee.
Good morning, Susan. That's right. On Monday, the Brazil Institute at the Woodrow Wilson International Center for Scholars and the Environmental Defense Fund brought together policy experts from India, China, and Brazil. They discussed how these emerging economies can help shape a climate deal crafted in Copenhagen in December. Now, the discussion looked more like a UN meeting than a Washington policy discussion. Many non-native English speakers listened through interpreters as panelist Marina Silva spoke. She's a senator for the Brazilian Amazon state of Acre. Brazil's most significant feature in the climate debate is that the Amazon is the largest carbon sink in the world. Silva said the country has already implemented strict deforestation goals, aiming to abate deforestation by 80% by 2020. Silva said China, India, and Brazil all must remember the world is changing, and it doesn't matter who caused the problem historically, it needs to be fixed. She called on all nations to agree to some emissions cuts from current levels. Another panelist, Kenneth Lieberthal, a China expert with the Brookings Institution, said if the U.S. and China can agree to some goals during bilateral talks in Beijing in November, that would boost prospects for Copenhagen. Ray Vickery from the Albright Stone Ridge Group, another panelist, said it's important to note that Brazil and India are democracies, and that could stymie efforts for concrete progress in Denmark. Internal politics may conflict with goals the countries agree to in Copenhagen. And we talked to Paulo Sotero, the director of the Brazil Institute, who said the world needs to be aware of issues in these three emerging nations because of their roles in achieving long-term climate goals.
Brought the three together because we wanted to do some sort of comparison. We believe those are three major new actors in the world scene, and I think we need to highlight more and more what they think and not only keep talking about what the developed world thinks. And this is obviously, as the Brazil Institute at the Wilson Center, part of our mission. And I think that I learned a lot from this event, and I hope everybody did.
Now, Sotero and others did say that bilateral talks and agreements over the past few months between India and China, China and the U.S., and trilateral talks among India, China, and South Africa are all moving in the right direction. They said the major steps they expect from Copenhagen are deforestation goals and a framework for sharing clean energy technology and helping developing countries with adaptation mechanisms.
Dee Bombani, thank you.